People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Terpy. Now, today I'm going to talk about the whole beachy stuff getting charged things. Because, you know what? I have to be honest. I have a couple of questions. Or not even say questions, but, you know, just some things show me say this whole hit where them put out on the wife, I think it's much bigger than even the beachy stuff and the two people they bring in. But before I go into that, everybody who was concerned about the dog, you know, the dog with them paint green. People, don't worry on yourself. It turns out the dog is a laborite. It's okay, the residents have confirmed that the dog, Rambo, is indeed a long-time supporter of the JLP. Matter of fact, if you look at your screen right now, you can see it for yourself, right? Trust me, people, you cannot make these things up. There it is, underlined in red. The resident says, him not even resist. And that is the dog him attack, by the way. Him not even resist. Him love it because him a labor right. I show why him so straight. People, Rambo clearly have a voter's ID. On September the 3rd, Rambo the mongrel, right, Rambo the dog, right, will be heading down to the polling station to cast his vote. People, I don't know. You know what? Because I read it and not hear it, because if me see it on a clip, then me at least can figure out if I truly mature or what, or if this brother is just an all-time classic comedian, right? But people, there you have it. Only in Jamaica, the dog is a labor right. The only country where even the dog them can cast a vote. But one thing me say, brother, this picture everybody I look on right now, it not really reflect well. Me tell you why. You see, because the whole idea that, you know, Rambo, you know, happy and he might get well looked after. That picture where we are looking right now on your screen, people, anybody who know about dog can look at that dog and tell actually something is wrong here. I don't think Rambo is as, how do I say, the people in my thing said them loving and nice to him, but I don't think Rambo agrees. Dog, people, look on the screen. Wag it way. People look on Rambo tail. Rambo tail is tucked. There's food on the ground and not even a go a fight. The dog is nervous. The dog is hesitant. The dog is fearful, right? The dog tail tucked. That dog don't look like a happy bouncing dog, but hey, I don't know, I just one picture. Right, but anyway, people, we could get into the beachy stout thing. Now people, as you can see on the screen, right, Everton McDonald, aka Beachy Stout or Mr. Mac, has been charged. But it's two conspirators. I don't know, the name them kind of confuse me. One of them, 30-year-old Asta Barnes, otherwise called Tiny. Right, now I don't know Asta, that sounds like a man name to me. But Tiny, I've never heard of a man nickname Tiny. That's kind of strange to me still, but it get even stranger. Because the next co-conspirator, 56-year-old Denver Lynn Minot, otherwise called Bubble, a fisherman of Rancho Portland. So Denver Lynn, nickname is Bubble, and it's a fisher. Hold on. So let's get this right. This fisherman name is Bubble. Bubble. So you have man up a Portland name Bubble. That in itself is a charge. He should be charged. Listen, we're gonna have to start until Jamaicans start get some nicknames that make sense. Right, and suit them gender. And I don't understand. No man is supposed to walk around with a name like Bubble. That alone, the police should have put a charge on him for. And Tiny, people. Anyway, let's get down into the $3 million. In my opinion, this thing is much bigger than Beachy Stout and Tiny and Bubble. $3 million sound inflated. That would be more than double with them pay to get rid of the JUTC chairman, Douglas Chambers. There is no hit in a Jamaica will require $3 million. $3 million to get rid of one woman? I think this is much bigger. Because remember, Tiny and Bubble are charged as co-conspirators. I think them are just the people them who facilitate certain things and, you know, they might move the money over there, link up with them. This thing is big. Now, $3 million can't go to no one hitman or even no two hitman. You can't tell me say $3 million. You go to somebody and say, listen, one with somebody named $3 million and Beachy Stout paid $3 million, unless Listen, maybe him just have it like that. All I'm saying is people based because I've dealt with so many of these cases, I have a general idea in my mind of what a hit costs, right? And when you hear, anytime you reach million, you're talking about high level targets. If you make somebody carry out a hit, right? Once you touch the millions, if it's somebody who is they hold a very high ranking position, you know, for example, as me say, JUTC chairman, then you have to go talk seven figures. But 90% of these seminar Jamaica, we are talking about 200,000 the most. People literally do it in some communities, and money do it for 10,000 and a spliff. Some money do it for your shoes. If the clerks clean enough money go carry out a hit for your pair of clerks. So this $3 million figure, that show me say this app's much bigger than them $3 million, right? That show me say, sure, it might give one man the $3 million. For example, I don't know Simple Simon, but let's say for example, a bubble of control wag one. Then they say, see $3 million, but make sure you say it first, it go towards this and go towards that. It can't be no $3 million finna hit. That does sound inflated to me. That sound extremely, extremely high, right? And I understand that Portland is a place where very low crime, right? Very, very low crime. So I understand that because there wouldn't be a surplus of killers down there. You might have to convince people a bit more with more money, right? For example, if you come from Spanish Town, right? If you link with certain man from clans, they may mash the works for $5,000. You have man in the clans where kill people for $5,000. That is a fact. People from Spanish Town know me talk about $5,000 and a Guinness. But I guess if you come from Portland, you know, a parish that with a very low murder rate, not acidic, right? You might have convinced people a bit more with a bit more money, but still, $3 million? I would love to see how them break that down. I would love to see how them break that down. That is a whole heap of money if you hit for one person, right? For one person, but again, people, what did I say in my old video? This whole argument say, oh, Beaches don't have money, so him can't get charged. Didn't I dismiss it? I dismissed it. See, Jamaica is the land of narratives. People just wall up on the narrative. Oh, from your have this take. No, listen, if somebody go forward and give the police information and willing to stand next to it, they might get charged. I said that. Here we are. This whole idea, and enough people get away because of this. You see that narrative? One of the reasons why I try to shake it is because enough people get away. Because Jamaican people make up their mind before the thing even reach a police station. So them tell themselves, you know what, but don't even go bother report it. But because him drive on Benz, police not lock him up. Listen, when people not go to court, when people not get charged, it just means that the police can't build a case. Right? Yet. Because to build a case, you need not just evidence, but in Jamaica, often you need somebody who will stand up and say, listen, I will say this down the road. Right, because most of our cases, most of them rely heavily upon a witness. No care who the person want me. This idea say, oh, well, forget about it because him name Beaches out and him have money, so nothing will come out that police don't go charge him. Him don't go station. I remember those arguments. But here we are, charged. Because clearly, somebody is talking. And the fact that them have the $3 million figure, that sure says somebody I work with them. Somebody is working with the police. Right. If somebody, when they hear people say, oh, that man have money on him, Boski, what them do? Is either them buy out the victim, go to the victim and say, see some money, don't pursue the case, and the victim take it, in which case, are them throw them owner justice for money, or them pay money to get rid of the witness. Right. But the idea say, oh, for you have more than $5 million in your bank account, then nothing can come out of it. It's just not true. Too much man get away from cases because Jamaican people make up their mind and say, nobody report it, nobody talk to this because they have money, so now come out of it. As if it's a foregone conclusion. It's not. It's not. This is the Beaches story to people that tell me, sir, 116. And nothing, him doing not spend one night in a station. See that? He's been charged. Now, obviously, him still have to go to court and him still have to go prove this and that. But he didn't have a solid witness. If somebody will be stand up, and as me say, from what I'm hearing, them have evidence and them have this and that. As me say, we will see. So again, well done to the police, right? Because them work. See, when time them do anything bad, the whole world, every celebrity, every artist need to post it. When them do good, people go silent. as me say, agents, right? But big up on yourself. I hope it can carry right through and it get sink, right? I hope it right up to the court date and all them things. They only know the witness protection thing already. I only know how, you know, things sticky. But hey, it's a start. We're moving in the right direction. We're moving in around this build confidence. This show other people say, listen, the man down the road will have the money where they do this. Then that means say, if me start tell the police and this, then that might happen to him too. Things like this increase the confidence of the public. Right? But while we are talking about charges, people listen to me. Tell me how much years J-Bad, Nevada Hodges, bigger crime, Sir D, etc. do in a prison. Can somebody tell me in the comment section? Don't waste your time. Zero. Why J-Bad and Hodges and all them money? Kill much people. Never yet go to prison. Is it because they're innocent? Is it because they're 116s? Is it because, oh, police not go for them because police treat them upper class? No, it's because police couldn't be that case. I'm getting tired of the lazy narrative. Jamaicans are obsessed with lazy thinking. The culture of those, oh, I could just hold a narrative and keep it for life. J-Bad never got a prison. Not because he was innocent. But because them couldn't be in the case. Nobody never go stand up and say, listen, me stand right side. I want to write to the end officer. Me going to court to testify against him. When police hold on up a man and Lego man, you know what I mean? See them innocent. The justice system is not to say who do it. The justice system don't lock up people based on what you know. Them lock up people based on what you can prove. It's not what you know, it's what you can prove. So J-Bad never got prison. He never getting a 30-40 years. I just never getting a 30-40 years. Right? None of them. Bigger crime never getting a 30-40 years. Police call them in, question them, and have to let them go. Because them can't be like yes. Not because they were innocent. So that's the takeaway for today's video. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.